Hello YouTube. It's been a while, but I've been pretty busy recently, so I haven't had much time to make a video. In my time off, I began watching and finished the sports anime Haikyuu, at least what's been released of it so far. I plan to read the manga soon, since I can't wait until an eventual season 4 is released. Now, my expectations going into Haikyuu were not very high, admittedly. I knew it was highly rated, but I just began to watch it out of boredom, really, instead of pure interest. My expectations with volleyball brings back some rather awkward times in high school gym class. So, as lame as it sounds, I had been pretty biased against it. Now, all this was blown away as I began to binge through season one. The image of Hinata standing atop of the stairs, looking onto Kageyama, promising to beat the king of the court once they enter high school, his winter jogs, and his pestering of his schoolmates to lend him a helping hand in his practices all contributed to Hinata becoming a character I was fond of, and seeing his growth has made me both proud and motivated. His cheery and innocent nature is one that is common in any protagonist of the shonen gene, but Shoyo is someone whose work isn't reliant on some crazy power-up or title of the chosen one. He's a scrapper, an underdog, a character who has fought and willed for every last bit of talent he has displayed, and even then, he has obvious flaws in his game that don't magically disappear because the plot demands it. Although he does make incredible saves and blocks at crucial points, it's due to his passionate motor and athleticism, which are things that he has worked for. Yet his weaknesses are still present. There are ones that we are reminded of every time he receives something with his head rather than his hands, or mistakes at block, or even his greed highlighted through some key parts, like the famous fight between him and Tobio. As the show progresses, he becomes at least passable to even decent at the things he lacked, but he is yet to become a complete player, as he doesn't have to. It's a team sport after all. Of course, it helps he has a strong unit of players around him, from the genius setter Kageyama to the fearless Nishinoya, guarding every inch of the court, captain among captains Daichi, whose balance brings the team harmony, the powerful set of strikers Tanaka and Asashi, to his partner in blocking Tsuki, who more than makes up for Hinata's shortcoming, since his strong points are Hinata's weaknesses. And even bench players like Suga and Yamaguchi have roles to play. Finally, the most crucial person to Hinata's development, the little giant. A phantom-like figure Shoyo chases as his idol and hero. The one who gave him hope that even he, whose height is no norm in the sport, can soar past the mightiest set of blockers. The little giant is used through the anime as a goal for Hinata to look ahead to. He wants to go to nationals since he saw him at the tournament that day he passed the TV on his bike. He followed him to Karasuno and was even gifted the same number as him. Info on the little giant is very limited as far as the anime, but one thing that is certain is he has a great impact on Hinata's dream. Now I'll get into some of the other characters besides Hinata that I would like to highlight. First of the characters that touched me the most, Shigahara, the former starting setter of Karasuno. Now at first he seemed to me a typical nice guy who happens to warm the bench, but the saddest point about him is that he wants to play, he wants to start, and isn't happy to be the backup. He strives and trains, but the genius and talent of Tobio is too much for him to overcome. Though he never tries to show his seniority to Tobio, never throws his weight around with the other first years, always kind and smiling. But the moments where he is competitive, the moments his eyes sparkle with the yearning to be a key player, that's when he breaks my heart. If he had simply accepted his role and was completely satisfied, or if he had shown bitterness at his junior, then Suga would have been a typical person. But what makes him outstanding is he tries his best while helping those around him get better. He gets up every day and hopes to play, and when he does, he is grateful for his opportunity. He has one of the strongest wills in the show. And knowing the quality of these people, that's saying a lot. Next is the charismatic captain of Obai Josai, Oikawa Toru. My favorite character, and the one I admire the most. Now this may sound strange to a lot of people, but I'll explain further. As a person who plays a sport, a leader like Oikawa is what I would like to become. To be able to lead a whole team and have the ones around you not only trust in your abilities, but be able to make them function to the best of their abilities, is a skill not many players have. His laid-back leadership, mixed in with his overwhelming arrogance, allows the others to lay themselves under his umbrella-like presence, while also not becoming shadows. He has a great balance as he shines as a star, but still leads the others in this seemingly lax but strong way. He's not perfect, as he is filled with a lot of pride and a tad of insecurity. His fear of Kageyama shows how scared he is of people who have natural talent. For someone like him, who wasn't born with the gift of natural genius, skill, he seems to have an intense hatred of individuals he views as threats. This can be seen in his treatment and attitude to both Kageyama and his kryptonite Ashijima. Oikawa is prideful, but a true lion on the court, and his effort can only be shown on the play against Karasuno. With the game on the line, the ball drifts out of bounds, but the calm captain runs towards it with full confidence. He points at his ace, Iwo-chan, and with that simple point, everyone understood as long as he jumped, the ball would be delivered to him. And just as promised, he delivers a perfect ball right into the powerful spike of Iwo-chan. He falls on the table, yet he gets up so fast he slips on the mat. But the look on his eyes was fully focused and ready to deliver victory for his side. Not only was his skill displayed, but also his tenacity. Oikawa is still the best setter I have seen in this anime. Kageyama may be a genius, but Oikawa is a leader and a servant of the team above all else, even if his personality contradicts that on the surface. I really felt for his character and found myself cheering for Obai Josai to go through to the finals, although a loss for them was most likely what was awaiting them. Overall, I hope to see more of him when I start reading the manga. Also, I would just like to point out that I do enjoy Kageyama a lot, and I think he's a great player. And I do not mean to take away from his development, because yes, he's naturally gifted, but he has worked his ass off to get to where he is. So I'm definitely not taking anything away from him. Now, overall, yeah, I hope to see him. I hope to see more of him when I read the manga. Oikawa, that is. For a moment, I would also like to discuss Tsuki. His growth through the journey, especially the later parts of season 2 and 3 as a whole, was extraordinary. From saying it's just a club to not wanting to miss one play in the finals, and pretty much leading them to victory, it was masterful writing. Tsuki, for a long time in the anime, was somebody who didn't seem to have any passion for the sport, and just in general was kind of an asshole to a lot of the people on the team. Now, all this, obviously, you know, knowing most people, there has to be a reason why he's acting like this, and we found out later the fact that he sees hard work as irrelevant because of what happened to his brother, who did not get to start a single game or play, even though Tsuki saw him working really hard and staying after school and trying his best, but he could not make the team. So he saw hard work as redundant, because to him, it doesn't matter how hard you work, there's always somebody who's naturally more gifted than you, and you know, you'll just be left in the sun in the end. Now, of course, Tsuki never really understood the fact that he already was talented enough to start, and he could be he could have been a better player faster if his attitude had simply changed. Now, it did change because eventually he did become so good that he became a key player, but that was only after certain events. And the scene that I still remember pretty much gave me goosebumps when I watched it was Season 3, Suki's block, the famous block. And afterwards, he remembers what he was told, where the moment he'll fall in love with volleyball is the moment that he'll start taking it seriously. And after that block, he finally shows open emotion when he puts his hand up and screams, "Yes!" Like he just did it, like in this victory. And everybody on the team gets super hyped because they've never seen Suki like that, and it was such a good moment. That was the moment that I realized that he's probably one of the most important players and one of the best characters in this anime. Now, that brings an end to this video. My uploading has been a bit weird thanks to my schedule, as I mentioned earlier, but I will upload more once in a while, and definitely more Haikyuu and more characters to talk about that I didn't mention in depth in this video. Even people like Suki and Kageyama, I still want to talk about them more because I just mentioned them sort of, especially Kageyama, which is one of my favorite characters. It's actually my second favorite character behind Oikawa. So, until next time, you two have a great day.